This snake is named after its terrestrial habitat, but many populations are actually semi-aquatic. This is Thamnophis elegans, the Western Terrestrial Garter Snake. Here's a Western Terrestrial Garter Snake, right along the Bow River in Calgary, Alberta. Got her! Wow, she's a beauty! Just got her to crawl under my sweater here, so she can calm down, and hopefully coil up. Western terrestrial garters were named so due to their primarily terrestrial habitats of grasslands, woodlands, and even elevations of up to almost 4,000 meters. However, populations in the Great Basin and the Rocky Mountains are semi-aquatic, so arguably, it's not the best common name at all. These snakes live throughout most of the western United States and Canada, as seen on this map. They are an adaptable species, living in a variety of habitats and being able to prey on a variety of animals, depending on what's available. This is known as polyphagism, and allows them to survive in places, such as Calgary, that more specialist species can't due to a lack of correct diet. Some main foods of the Western Terrestrial Garter Snake include small fish, frogs, and toads, grasshoppers, mollusks, earthworms, caterpillars, salamanders, small rodents, small lizards, and leeches. And they even exhibit cannibalism of smaller Western Terrestrial Garter Snakes, as well as other snake species. In fact, coastal populations don't view fish as a food source at all, sometimes even starving while possible fish prey are nearby. This is in contrast to inland populations, where fish are a major part of their diet. Western terrestrial garter snakes are generally a brown color, with one light-colored dorsal stripe and two similar darker stripes, one on each side. Some individuals have dark spots between the stripes, like this one. But this species is highly variable, with some varieties having orange spots or even reddish lateral stripes. Like the common garter snake, which you can watch our video of here, Western terrestrial garter snakes possess a mild venom in their saliva. This species' venom has myonecrotic, or muscle-killing, effects. Though it's not dangerous to humans, rarely causing local swelling, as these snakes lack the venom-injecting fangs of dangerous species, such as pit vipers. And these snakes are also unlikely to bite humans. I've certainly never been bitten by any garter snake, and I've picked up hundreds. Though they probably will must on you. That is, excrete a foul-smelling liquid from glands near the anus. And just to remind you, if you're not 100% certain about a species identification on a snake or any animal, do not pick it up, please. They are also the only species of garter snake documented to kill prey through constriction, though much less efficient than other snakes such as boas or gopher snakes. A combination of envenomation and constriction are used to subdue and swallow their prey. The Western terrestrial garter snake belongs to the order Squamata, along with the other lizards. Yes, I say other lizards, because snakes are lizards themselves, because the order Serpentes, the snakes, are right in the middle of the lizard clade. Within Serpentes, it belongs to the Cynophidia clade, along with 80% of all snakes, within which it belongs to the family Calibridae, along with the king snakes, rat snakes, hognose snakes, water snakes, green snakes, and even the deadly boomslang. Within the family Natricinae, the genus Thamnophis appears to be sister to the water snakes of the genus Neurotia. Unlike the common garter snake, whose position within Thamnophis is clear, the exact position of Thamnophis elegans is less clear. Some sources place them next to some Mexican species, as seen on this tree. But other recent sources instead separate Thamnophis into two major clades, placing Thamnophis elegans in a widespread clade near the aquatic giant Sierra Northwestern Plains and Butler's garter snake, as seen on this tree. Like all garter snakes, Western terrestrial garter snakes do not lay eggs. Instead, being ovoviviparous, they give birth to 8 to 12 young in August or September, like this little mate I found here. Look how beautiful this large female is. Let's release her here where we first found her. You're all right, mate. You're all right. She's very calm. What a beauty. Here's another individual laying still on the river's edge. And look at this, a school of small fish, lake chubs most likely. She's staying very still and flicking her tongue to feel the environment. She's hunting these minnows. Let's leave her to her hunt, as she seems a bit nervous. There's another here. A smaller male. See the darker lateral stripes on this one? Western terrestrial garter snakes are an incredibly interesting species. Until next time, on Animal Analysis.